IVM.
Hello and welcome to the Habit Coach Podcast, the bite-sized podcast filled with quick and easy actionable habits. Remember, great habits create that awesome life. I am Ashton Doctor, your Habit Coach. And today's fun fact of the day has to do with lending systems. Did you know that the first official lending system started about 3,000 years ago in ancient Rome and Greece? This was the system that is used today by pawn shops or pawn brokers. This is where someone gives you something of value that they own in return for money in exchange. A certain interest rate is also identified at the time of exchange. Once the money plus that interest rate has been returned, the pawn shop gives back that item of value it was holding. And after a stipulated time, if the money plus interest is not returned, the pawn shop sells off the item it has in possession to recover the money loaned out. This is where we often hear those horror stories of people losing their family jewels. Pun not intended, but where they put up their wife's jewelry for a loan and are then unable to pay it back. In India, we had the zamindar system, which was also like a form of lending, where the zamindar would give loans and in return, the person would work in their fields to pay them back or pay the zamindar in produce from that land. The problem with that system is that the zamindars would give loans at ridiculous rates, so high that the people could not pay that amount back and had to work their entire lives for it. And hence, the system turned into a form of slavery. What is important in all methods of lending is an interest rate. This is to protect the person giving the money. It is not a function of greed or, you know, that wanting extra money. It is protection. Very often we are asked by our friends or family for money. Please give me this much and I will pay you back in a few months. We feel awkward about loaning our hard-earned money, but then they tell us this urgent story that they need it and without it, things are going to be very difficult for them. So we then end up giving in and giving that loan to them. This is where most of our problems start. We wait eagerly for that day when they promise to give the money back. Yet that day comes and goes, no sign of the money. In your mind, you're wondering, how would you have invested that money? It would have earned you so much in return. Yet nothing, not a peep from them about the money. You suddenly hear that they bought a new car or they went on an international holiday. Now your blood is boiling. Bloody hell. They have money for a new car? No money to return their loan? You meet them at social events and act like everything's okay? Then you subtly try and tell them, about that money you have of mine? And they brush the topic aside and worse yet, get angry at you for bringing this topic up. Outside, you are smiling. Inside, you are boiling. Chances are, you might never get that money back. If you are lucky, you will. But one thing is for sure, you have ruined a friendship, you have ruined a relationship, and caused yourself unnecessary stress. As your habit coach, I want you to live a life of ease, a life not bound or tied up in situations outside your control. Hence, today's habit comes as a principle for life. You must have an unwavering principle when it comes to lending money. This is something that I learned from one of our family friends who's one of the wealthiest people in India. So you can imagine the number of people that would be coming to him asking for money. He will either give you money with a standard interest rate and a standard payback plan. Everything in black and white. The interest is of course lesser than the banks. But however, the interest rate adds that next level of seriousness. The other option is a blanket principle that you will never loan money to a friend or a family. No matter who it is, no matter how much, small, big, doesn't matter. It is very interesting when you give this clear, definite no, the person asking for money understands. You know, if you have a wavering, unsure, let me think about it kind of no, that's when they take offense. Do not lend money if you do not know how to secure it. You worked hard for it. It is yours. They have no claim to it just because they are in need. And I know this sounds heartless, but this is true. You have to be logical when it comes to this. You can help them in other ways. You can support them in many ways. A loan does not have to be one of them. The final thing you can do is not loan money to them, but give money to them and not expect it back in return. You can add this money as your way of doing charity, but do not expect the money back. They may make promises to return, and if they do, it's a bonus. If they do not, no problem, you had already written it off. This way, you will only give away money that you do not need. So your simple habit when it comes to lending money starts by creating a definite principle. Decide you will never just lend money to someone. If you do, there will be an interest rate and a payback period. Or give the money away. Do not loan it away. Be very clear about the way you stand with regards to lending. Create these principles in life. They will support you for a long time going forward. Don't live in stress. It is so unnecessary. So start these habits and share with us your progress using the hashtag TheHabitCoach. If you like this podcast, don't forget to check out other interesting podcasts on the IVM network. You can listen to us on the IVM Podcast app or ivmpodcast.com. You can also follow us on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Twitter and Instagram. If you want to reach out to me, I am Ashton Doc on Twitter and Instagram. You can find lots more information on my website, awesome180.com, or check out different content on my YouTube channel called AWESOME180. That's awesome180.
I hope you enjoyed that show. If you aren't following us on social media, please do. We're IVM Podcasts on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. We'd like to thank the sponsors on the network this week. See, Ed, we really do appreciate your support. We have a new show on the network. It's called The Fighting Goat. And if you love fighting sports, tune in every Wednesday with hosts Arjun and Somesh. They also featured, by the way, on Cyrus Says this week, where the three fitness freaks bonded over their love for TV sports and sports in general. Tune in to This Round Is On Me, where Gauri celebrated her 25th anniversary with Kavita Rajwade, who is my co-founder at the IVM Podcast Network. They give us details about how this show was curated, and they talk about podcasts in general. On The Habit Coach, Ashton highlighted our addiction to screens, how we are glued to either a big laptop screen or a small mobile screen all day. He shared some tips on how to rectify this unhealthy lifestyle. On All Things Policy, Anirudh Kanisetty spoke to Prateek Wagre and Rohan Sheth about the new internet guidelines that were issued by the Government of India recently and their impact on content creators and platforms. On the Filter Coffee podcast, Karthik invited Vivek Ram, who is a celebrated animation artist. They chatted about his stint with animation and starting his own studio called Vanar Sena, bringing to life stories from ancient India and his scriptures with animation as his vehicle. We had Dhanya Rajendran, the editor of the News Minute, on The Note with Maruk Inayat. It was a deep dive into the digital newsroom and the upkeep of truth in a fake news pandemic. And with that, we hope to see you again next week.
Come learn and experience the ABCDs of being queer with me, Shunetro.
And me, Farhad.
On our show, Gay BCD.
The two of us take you through our stories and experiences of being gay men in the city of Mumbai and have candid
and sometimes downright scandalous
conversations about sexuality, gay culture, and everything in between.
Catch new episodes of Gay BCD every Tuesday on the IVM Podcasts website, app, or wherever you get all your podcasts from.